I'm Suzanne Smiley with Atlas RFID Store, and we're here at RFID Journal Live 2013. I'm here with Debbie Power at the Thing Magic booth. How are you doing, Debbie?
I'm great. How are you?
Doing good. She's going to tell us a little bit more about Thing Magic, the company. Can you tell us about how you got started and just the overview?
Sure. So Thing Magic started in about year 2000. We were founded by five gentlemen getting their PhDs in physics at MIT. So we continue to have a lot of roots in MIT and there. And we've always been focused on UHF RFID. That is our niche and our specialty. We have continued to develop and evolve products over the years. We have a number of firsts. We did the first software-defined radio. Our modules are used in many commercial applications, and I'll show you those in a minute. Around the world. We had the first tool tracking application in trucks for tracking tools, and we have a great range of products.
Well, fabulous. So I see you have some here for us today. Can you explain a little bit more and take us through what y'all brought to RFID Journal?
Sure. And so we have kind of two product areas that we specialize in. We have modules for customers that want to embed UHF RFID into their products and essentially UHF enable them, such as cabinets, printers, handheld devices, and so I can show you some of those.
All right.
We have a family of modules that range from, at the high end, we have our M6E module, which is a 4-port, 1-watt module. We have the M5E, which is a 1-watt 2-port module. We have the new Micro, which is a 1-watt 2-port module. And we have the Compact, which is a 200 milliwatt 1-port module. So we offer a range of form factors and performance points and price points for our customers to select from.
And what would the customers be doing with these?
They would be embedding them in products. Okay. So we have some examples here.
Oh, great. Okay.
For instance, here we have a reader that's made by a company called Acora in Brazil that's meant for tolling application. And they use our M6E, our high-performance M6E product for basically tolling applications such as you would see here in the States.
Oh, like toll booths.
Toll booths and things like
that.
Gotcha.
Okay.
Then here is a couple of examples of the Micro. And you can see here, there's a company called Keon in Spain, in Barcelona. And they make a reader engine for Kanban panels that are used in hospitals, for shelf readers. So they have a number of different form factors of antennas and other devices which they use this to drive.
Right.
And then I didn't mention when you asked about the company, we were purchased by Trimble.
Okay.
About 2.5 years ago.
Okay.
Which has been a really wonderful thing.
Right.
Trimble is a large publicly held company, about $2 billion in revenue, over 5,000 employees. And they didn't have any UHF RFID. They're mostly known for global positioning. So the combination of those two technologies makes for some really interesting applications and for asset tracking, not only in the world, but also within a building or
a warehouse.
Boat or a warehouse or whatever.
Right, so, right.
This is a product, you can see the yellow outline is a product that they have had. This is a handheld mobile computing device, and they have used our Micro module to build into their Juno product here, which is also a UHF RFID reading device.
Okay.
So this is, I don't have it turned on, but but this is another example of, you know, one of our design goals for this product was high power but low power consumption,
right.
High read rate. So we have a range of very high performance products.
And that'd be for asset tracking. Is that what you were saying?
Yes, yes. Asset tracking, asset finding.
Okay.
It can be also be used for people tracking, for tracking inventory and the work in process involved. Those are some of the major applications.
Okay.
And then we take our modules and build them into finished readers as well.
All right.
So
I see this Thing Magic USB reader too.
Yeah,
I see.
We have the USB reader.
We sell a good deal of those.
Which has got the compact inside.
Okay, great.
And it is a very simple, easy to use, cost effective device that attaches to the USB port of your PC or even a mobile computer. And it's got an integrated antenna, so it gets all its power and communication and control from your PC. And it can be used to simply read and write small quantities of tags.
Right.
And I know Atlas, for instance, has done a tool check-in, check-out application
right.
based on the USB
reader. On the USB reader. I mean,
yeah.
It's a great little reader. It's perfect for what most people are looking for getting started, getting reading and writing, just
yes.
specific things done.
Exactly.
So, and we love selling them too. So
yeah, yeah.
That's
no,
great.
They're really, portable. I carry one around in my backpack.
Oh,
so at any time I can.
You can read our buddy chips. You can read mine.
I
have one on here.
Exactly.
All right, and then you got your M6.
Yes, and so then we also have our M6, which uses the Mercury 6E as its integral engine. And this is a networked reader. So this can be an autonomous reader that's sitting on the network. You can attach 1 to 4 antennas to it. It can have integrated Wi-Fi, in which case you would have a black Wi-Fi antenna that sticks up. You can power it either DC or AC. You could use a battery as well. It has GPIO ports so that it could be used to light a light or sound a buzzer. Or if you have something, a motion sensor, it can trip a read. It connects with Ethernet, and it can be used power over Ethernet as well. So if you have an Ethernet attachment somewhere but not power, it could be used for that. Some of the things that I think are special about our M6 reader are the integrated Wi-Fi that I mentioned before. Even with PoE, it can still run 31.5 dBm coming out of the ports, which allows you to have long cable runs, and it accounts for insertion loss. So you can still get to the FCC maximum of 30 dBm into the antenna. It also has a small Linux processor inside. So if you want to put some small application software on the processor inside the box, you can do that. So that you're not sending lots of tag identification data across the network and making your network very busy.
Right.
You can put some logic here to sort out, filter out the tag data reads that are not important.
Right.
So,
great.
And so everything I said about this product is also our Astra integrated reader, which is essentially got the Mercury 6 device inside here, but it has an attached antenna on this side, and it has an option for a second antenna right here. And this one has integrated Wi-Fi, so you can see the Wi-Fi is inside, it's not something outside. And these both support LLRP, which is share. And we find that some customers, when they're doing an installation, they might need 1 or 2 read points or antennas at a certain location. They might use some of these. If they have other places where they need 4 read points, they could use the Mercury 6. Again, the same software interface for both. So it's a nice suite of products to select from.
Right, and that has your antenna and your reader, so it's easy to use and good for buying purposes, cost effective.
Yeah, and actually very easy to install. We have the VESA mounts that you could put this on an articulating, same as a TV would be mounted on. But also, if you are hanging it from the ceiling, we have this other mount, so you can just screw it up into the ceiling.
Right, okay.
So it's really simple if you have PoE to just put one of these in. It's very simple.
Well, that's great. All right, what do y'all have over here?
And the other product that I didn't mention is our Vega reader, which is a very specialized reader for designed for in-vehicle use. So it's got it needs to be attached over a serial connection to a computer. For instance, I mentioned before the in-vehicle reader for tool tracking. This is the product that we use for that. It's designed to be connected to a DC battery in a vehicle, and it has a special adapter so that if the car is turned off or the vehicle is turned off, it's not draining power from there. So that's another one that I wanted to be sure to mention. And then our development kits, I should say, all of these products come with development kits. We have an example of a module development kit, but basically what we do is we try to make it very easy for customers to be able to start using our products right out of the box. That's been a big focus of ours. So any development kit would come with either the module in a easy to use test bed enclosure, or one of these finished readers would come with whatever USB cable to attach to your PC, an antenna cable and a sample antenna, a bag of sample RFID tags packaged by Atlas RFID.
Thank you for the shout out.
You're welcome. So that right away you can attach it to your PC and start reading and writing tags.
Immediately.
Yeah, in half an hour or so.
So it just comes with everything you need. It's easy to use, and ThinkMagic are very reliable, so you know that you can get that when you get the development kit.
Exactly, exactly.
Great. Well, you have anything else you want to show us today?
Yeah, I do want to show you one other thing.
Great.
So along the lines of and I think I mentioned the Mercury API runs across all of these products. So we have one development environment that supports .NET, Java, C#, that runs across all of all of our products. But in addition, we've been working really hard on developing a user interface called the Universal Reader Assistant, which you can download from our website. And you can see there are five main functions that we've developed. One is just to read a lot of tags, and we even have this format where you can see from across the room how it works. And the goal of this product, again, is to make it very easy to read and write tags right out of the box. So if you are designing your solution for the first time, it gives you a chance. I can try different antennas, I can try different tags, see which one
just
gives
test.
Me the best results. And also, after you've developed your application, when it comes to installing it, and you want to know, how do I want to tweak this antenna, you can, from across the room, see, are my tags being read better or worse,
right.
and tune your system. So with this, you can read a lot of tags. You can also write to tags. There's a write EPC. There's something called Tag Inspector. So you can, let's see what we've got here. So it just picked up on a tag, and it's an NXP G2IL Plus tag. So if you're wondering what a tag is,
you've got all the information,
you've got
right?
All of that.
Right.
And then
right.
We have other functions where you can change what's in user memory, and then many tags have a lock and unlock feature, so
right.
It gives you access to this. Now, as you may know, in the Gen 2 protocol, which is what all our readers support, the ISO 18K6C protocol, there are a number of settings which are pretty down in the weeds to understand.
Yeah.
So there's
complicated.
Yeah. So we also, you can choose here whether you want to read continuously, whether you want to read 100 milliseconds on, 100 milliseconds off, and see how that changes the behavior of your system. There are different methods for switching from for the different antennas. There's queue values and session numbers and all kinds of things that can be automatic. You can say, I have a couple of tags moving fast through the field, sort of a racing kind of application,
right.
or you have many tags moving a little slower, and we will pick the Gen 2 settings that make the most sense for your application.
Okay, great. Just making it easier for the customer to test.
You can adjust the power, you know, up and down, from 30 watts down to 5.
Right.
So again, just kind of demystifies all that, but lets you pick the settings to best optimize your application.
Well, that's great, and definitely great for our customers who are looking, especially for the development kits, to get their hands in RFID and get you started and testing and figure out what they're going on. That helps them figure out what's the best tag, what's the best antenna, what's the best read, all that kind of stuff. So that's great. Well, Debbie, thank you so much for joining us.
Really
appreciate it. We love selling ThingMagic products, so we had to come by and talk to you for a little bit. I hope you're having a great time at RFID Live.
Thank you.
It's great.
You too.
And thank you again.
All right.
All right.